Hello everyone, this is EC251, Introduction to Electronics. Now, today we will see what are the different BJT biasing circuits and how we can solve the numerical based on this. Now, our first biasing circuits is fixed biasing circuit. In the fixed biasing circuit, the emitter is directly connected to ground, and the other two terminals, that is base and collector, they are connected to a particular resistance, and that resistance is connected to the VCC or the source of voltage. Now suppose this is the VCC. And this is the transistor. Now in the transistor, this is the collector terminal. So as this is the collector terminal, this resistance is collector resistance, and this point is base point. So this resistance is base resistance. And emitter is directly connected to ground. This kind of circuits is called fixed biasing circuit. Now we have to solve this circuit. So obviously the VCC, RB and RC, some particular values will be given for numerical. Now for solving this kind of circuit, we will take the particular loop and we will use KVL or Kirchhoff's voltage law. Now there are two capacitors also in this circuit, that is for the input part and output part. That is, this is the input AC input point, this is, and the capacitor is C1. And this is the output AC output point, and the capacitor is C2. So this is the total circuit. Now while doing the DC analysis, as this two circuit is, it is applicable whenever input and output is connected. So that means whenever we are using to determine our Q point, that time this portion and this portion we can neglect, and we will use two type of loop, that is the input loop and output loop. So in this circuit you can see the input, here emitter is grounded, so the input point is our base point. So base emitter loop is our input loop. So what we will take, first we will remove this capacitor part. Next, for taking the input portion, that means collector is output, that we are, for time being we are removing this one. Now this is VCC, and this VCC is actually the input voltage source, and if we represent this VCC as a battery, so its negative terminal will be connected to the ground. That means what we can do, the VCC, it's a positive VCC, that is positive voltage is given, that positive voltage we can write just like this. So here you can see the same circuit can be represented like this also. Here the positive point is connected to the base resistance. So this is the same as we have done just seen previously, and that time only the positive terminal was given. Now here, for the sake of the circuit, we are taking the negative terminal also. It is connected to the ground. Then this is also ground, this is also ground. That means it is a closed loop. So as this is the positive terminal, this is the direction of flow of current. So current will flow in this direction. So if current is flowing in this direction, we can take a Kirchhoff's voltage law or KVL in this input loop, that is base emitter loop. So number one is base emitter loop. Now let us start with this point. This is ground. We will go in this direction and we will come back to ground again. So ground to ground, it is the same point. Now as this is the same point and we are going to the direction of current, so from starting here, our first point is the negative terminal of VCC, so it is minus VCC. Then this is the direction of current, so this will be positive terminal, this will be negative terminal, and this is base terminal. So that means the current flowing in this resistance is our base resistance. Base current it is going, and this is base resistance. So what we can write, and first terminal is positive, first encounter with positive point, so it will be plus RB into IB, because this point base current is flowing. This is the base terminal. Now up to this it is base terminal and this is emitter terminal. So this is two different terminal, and as there is two different terminal, the voltage between base and emitter will be VBE. Now in the case of VBE, we can see this is the base emitter junction of the transistor, and we know that the first PN junction of the transistor is generally forward biased for making the Q point at the active region. So VBE is forward biased PN junction, and if is it forward biased PN junction, that means the voltage drop is 0.7 volt, that is fixed, that we know. And this side is our voltage source at the base point. Emitter point is connected to down, positive, negative. So we are going in this direction. So first we encounter with positive terminal. So it is plus VBE. Then we come to ground. We started with ground only. That means our loop is complete. So this is our KVL equation. This is equal to 0, we can write. Now in this equation, the value of VCC, it is known, value of RB is known, value of VB is 0.7 volt, it is also known. So only one unknown parameter is there, that is IB or base current. So we can simply write IB equal to VCC minus VBE divided by, this is going to the right side, this is RB. Okay. Now for any circuit, the values will be given. Suppose this is given 20 volt, suppose this is given 1 kilo ohm. So we can simply write whatever the value is given. Like this, we can simply put the values and we will get the value of base current. So base current we get from the first loop, that is called our base emitter loop. Now we coming to the second loop, that is the output terminal loop. In this circuit, the output terminal is collector and emitter is common. So our second terminal is collector base loop. So in collector base loop, we have to draw the circuit and we have to again calculate for the unknowns. Now first let us draw the second or the output portion of the circuit, which we have just omitted for the first loop. This is collector point, collector resistance. In emitter there is no resistance, so only VCC, this voltage source is given. This we have taken as a battery and the positive terminal is connected, which was given as VCC. Negative terminal we have taken as ground, so that with respect to ground, VCC voltage is given at the collector junction with respect to this RC resistance. Now this will be the direction of flow of current. So in this way we will write the KVL equation. Now one thing, the IB current, value of IB current we have taken from this first loop, that is base emitter loop. Now here what we will do, we know the equation IC equal to beta times IB, because beta is the ratio of IC by IB. So collector current and base current, this ratio is called beta. So using the value of beta in a numerical, generally value of beta is given. So suppose value of beta is 100, so whatever the value of IB we got from this first loop, we just simply multiply it with the beta and we will get the collector current. Now if we know the collector current, what we do, we just simply write the second equation, that is using KVL. We start from this point ground, we will come back to again ground, so both ground is potential zero, so we come to the same point and we are going to the direction of current, because current is going in this direction, so this point will be positive, this point will be negative. And this is collector point, this is emitter point, so this voltage will be VCE. This is plus, this is minus. Okay. Now coming to KVL, this is first, so this will be minus VCC, minus VCC. Then current is going in this direction, this will be positive point, so plus RC IC. Next we are coming to the this voltage potential drop, so this is VCE and this is positive, so plus VCE we can write. And we are coming to the ground from where we have started, so our equation is complete, equal to zero. Now here the unknown is VCE, so we can simply write here VCE equal to this, we go to the right hand side, that is VCC minus RC IC. Now in this equation VCC is given, RC is given, IC we have just found multiplying beta with base current, so this also known, so these three parameter is known, so VCE we will get. Now suppose any particular point voltage we need to know, for example VB, that is equal to VBE, and in E is connected, emitter is connected to ground, so that means it is 0, so it is equal to, both are same, so it is 0.7 volt. Suppose VE we want to know is connected to ground, so this is 0 volt. Suppose VC we want to know, so as emitter is connected to ground, so VCE will be equal to VE. So we got all the unknown parameters, whatever current or voltage we want to solve, all the points we can get just like this. So this is our fixed biasing circuit. How to calculate it, how to solve it, this is done. Now coming to our next circuit, our second circuit is emitter biasing circuit. It is almost similar to our first circuit, which is fixed biasing circuit. The only difference is here emitter circuit, that is emitter resistance is also given, which was not present at the first case. So this is the circuit diagram of emitter biasing circuit. We can see the only difference with fixed biasing circuit is that RE. So only this is extra in this case. Now again same procedure we will follow. So whenever we want to solve this, first as we are solving only for DC, this portion and this portion we are omitting. And first we are taking same case, that is base emitter loop, this we are taking. Now so for time being we are omitting this battery resistance because it is at the output portion, and VCC we will like the same, we will draw like this. So again we will write the KVL equation. So with the direction of the current we are taking, so first starting from this point, first point is minus VCC, next is IB RB, next is this voltage drop, this is plus VBE. This is same case we have seen just in the previous case for fixed biasing circuit. Now this is extra, this is IERE, because emitter current will flow in the emitter terminal. We have reached to the ground, so again we are completing our circuit. That is, loop is complete. Now here one thing is given, previous only IB was the unknown parameter, so easily we have calculated it. Now today what we are seeing in this circuit, that IB and RE, there are two unknown parameter, equation is only one, so we cannot solve it. We have to maximum we can solve one unknown for one given equation. So now we want to take these two parameters into a single parameter. Now what we can do, we know that our emitter current is actually combination of base current and collector current. And we also know that collector current is beta times of base current. So we can take that IE equal to beta plus 1 times of base current. So this we can substitute here. So what we take in case of IE, we don't write IE, we just write IB into beta plus 1. So in case of IE, we are substituting this one. So whatever rest we can simply write as it is, only IE equal to beta plus 1 times of IB. So the rest of the equation we are writing as it is. So IB we take common. So in the first case it is only RB, in the second case it is beta plus 1 times of RE. So this is the two points from where IB is present there. So we have taken common. Rest of thing we can shift to the right hand side. So equal to VCC minus VBE. So what do we do? VCC and VBE, these two is shift to the right hand side. So VCC has become positive and VBE has become negative. So now the value of IB is simply VCC minus VBE divided by RB plus beta plus 1 times. Okay. So in this case, VCC is known, VB is 0.7 volt. Always, because it is followed by spin junction. RB is given, beta is given, RE is given. So we can calculate the value of IB. Whatever may be the values of this parameters is given, we can calculate the value of IB. Now if we know the value of IB, we simply multiply it with beta. Value of beta is given, so we get collector current. Now as we get collector current, we can solve the output loop, that is our collector emitter loop. So coming to output terminal, that is collector emitter loop. Here also we write the KVL. So just first draw the circuit. The VCC will shift to that portion. So again we draw the circuit of output portion. This is collector resistance. So VCC we draw in this. Now what we do? This is the direction of current. We start from this and we go in the direction of current. So first we encounter minus terminal of VCC, so this is minus VCC. Then this is the flow of current, so obviously first point is positive, so and this is collector terminal, so current flowing is collector current, so plus IC RC. Now this is collector terminal, this is emitter terminal, so VCE is the voltage drop present here, plus VCE. Next is plus RE IE equal to 0. So here we know that RC value is the beta times of IB that we already got. IE we don't have. So what we do? We take the approximation that IC is almost equal to IE, because we know that in a circuit base current is very very less. So we just simply replace the IE with R with IC. So emitter current and collector current is almost same, so then this will take. Rest of the equation we will write as it is. So IC is here and here, so we just take common of this. IC of common RC plus this is RE. This 2 we take to the right hand side, so this is plus VCC minus VCE. So in this case IC is known. Okay, so in the first loop beta current was base current was unknown, so that we have determined. Now here VCE is unknown, so what we do, just VCE equal to that we will determine. Rest of thing we will take to the right hand side. So this is VCC minus IC into RC plus RE. This is the value of VCE. So from this VCE we are getting from this equation, it is VCC minus IC into this will take common RC plus RE. Now if we know this VCE, we have to just put the values, whatever the values are given for VCC, IC we know, beta times IB, and these two resistance is given. So we just put the this values and we will get the value of VC. Now we will take we have to determine several voltages. For example, suppose we need to know what is collector voltage, what is emitter voltage, suppose what is base voltage, like that. So just see, this point is collector point, so we have to know this point, what is the voltage of, what is the voltage of at what is in this point. If we want to come, we can start from here, that is it is zero, ground we know, with VCC. This point is VCC, so this point is VCC. If we subtract this, then we will get to this point, because this is the highest point, because there is only one source in this circuit, and this is up to, if we go in this direction, we come to the down. So we can write VCC minus IC RC. So we came to the this point. Okay, there is another point. If we want to reach to the collector, we can grow from this point also, because this is zero. As we go to this VCC, our voltage will be up. So we can also write this is RE IE, or we can write RE IC also plus VCE. If we add these two points, we can also come to the collector voltage point. Now if we want to know the emitter, what is the voltage at emitter point, so we can from zero we can just add this voltage and we come to this point. So this is REIE or ICRE. If you want to know what is the base point voltage, we simply add emitter voltage with this voltage drop, that is VVE, it is 0.7. So in this way we can find out the voltages at each terminal. Now coming to the third biasing circuit, our third biasing circuit is voltage divider biasing circuit. So voltage divider biasing circuit, we again start with the same point VCC. This is collector resistance RC. What is the voltage now? That is VC, but resistance we take as RC. This is emitter terminal, so this is RE. Up to this point it is similar to emitter biasing circuit, but the difference lies here. There is not one resistance, there are two resistances that is connected with base. This is the difference from the previous thing. So we denote it as R1 and R2. So before going for loop analysis, we have to know that what is the combined effect of these two resistances in base. Without that we cannot know. So what we do, we first take base analysis. So in base analysis we take only the base point and now just see here, base point is connected with a junction point of R1 and R2. So base point is connected to junction point of R1 and R2. R2 is coming to ground. So R2 is coming to ground with the junction point. R1 is coming with to VCC. So with the junction point, R1 is coming to VCC. So both are ground, so we can simply connect them to make a loop. Now if we see from this emitter, from this point, if we look to the base, what are the combination of these circuits will be the effective point at base. So what we take, we take Thevenin's equivalent. We take Thevenin's equivalent resistance for equivalent resistance of two base. We take Thevenin's equivalent voltage for the equivalent voltage at base point. So first take Thevenin's equivalent. Suppose first we take Thevenin's equivalent resistance. So So we know the how to take Thevenin's equivalent. First we have to vanish all the voltage and current source. So voltage source is there, so we just simply sort it. Now you can see R1 at to this point is common and R1 at to this point is also common. That means both R1 and R2 are in parallel. That is the combined effect to base point. So this is RTH. Next we do what is our Thevenin's equivalent voltage. Now to get the Thevenin's equivalent voltage, Thevenin's equivalent voltage at base point, that is whatever the voltage is applied, voltage is seen at base point with respect to ground. With respect to ground, whatever the voltage is given, that is base point. So if we see this loop, the current will be obviously VCC divided by R1 plus R2, because this is the only, in this loop this is the only voltage source, and these two at this point, these two resistance are in series. So this is the current multiplied by R2. If we take, that will give the value of voltage across R2, and what is R2? One point is ground, another point is base. That means at base with respect to ground, whatever the applied voltage, that is the voltage across R2. So this we can write as VTH. So base analysis is done. Now what we do, we take the first equation, that is our base emitter loop. So now what we take, we don't take R1 and R2, we simply take the Thevenin's equivalent resistance, that is RTH, which is combination of R1 and R2. In this case it is parallel, and next it is given the VTH. Now in this loop we can simply write the KVL equation. So suppose we start from ground point coming to this direction, that is the direction of current. So it is minus VTH plus RTH, it will be multiplied with the base current. RTH IB is the two junction. So you just take the voltage difference VBE, and this is current is flowing in this direction, this is positive, so it is IEI. This is equal to 0. Now what do you know, that emitter current, that is IE, is equal to combination of collector current and base current. Collector current is beta times IB. So emitter current is actually IB multiplied by beta plus 1 times. So this IE we can replace by beta plus 1 times I. This I we replace. The rest equation we write as it is. So here we are solving for IB. So what do we do? The rest of thing we just shift to the right hand side. So VTH. This one is simple to right hand side, minus VB, that is 0.7. And if you take IB, that is this will be RTH plus beta plus 1 times of I. So here we are getting the base current. Now we will get the collector current, that is IC equal to beta times IB, and this collector current we can take for the right hand side, that is collector, emitter, loop. So collector emitter loop we will start when we know what is the collector current. Now take the circuit for collector emitter loop. This is RC, this is VCC. So this loop is just the same loop which we have just seen for emitter biasing circuit. This loop there is no change. So whatever the equation we can write for this KVL, simply it is also applicable for this side, that is collector side or output side loop for voltage divider biasing circuit. Only the input loop, that is the base emitter loop, was different. So this KVL we can write as it is, like emitter biasing circuit output loop. Next, coming to the fourth type of biasing circuit, that is DC feedback biasing circuit. So in this case, first to draw the circuit, this portion is same. The difference is this is feedback, so output terminal, this is collector terminal, is connected to base terminal, that is the input terminal. This is called RP. This is the difference from the previous circuit. So this is the circuit for DC feedback biasing circuit. Now here again we do the same analysis. For DC circuit analysis, this collector portion, this both collector and base, the capacitor is omitted, so this we have done. Now what we do, we take the VCC in the format of a battery. So this is VCC. So what we write, this current as IC dash, this current as IC, this current as IB, because at this point this two branch is differentiating. So again writing the KVL equation, minus VCC plus IC dash RC coming to this one, that is plus IB RB plus VBE plus IE RE equal to 0. So in this case we know that IC dash, it is a this current and this is the IC. We know that base current is very much less, so what we write the approximation that IC bar, IC dash, this current is almost equal to IC. So minus VCC plus IC RC plus IB RB plus VBE plus this is RE. So here emitter current will flow. So emitter current we are simply writing almost equal to IC. IC RE equal to 0. Now what we can take, the IC equal to beta times IB. So minus VCC plus beta times IB into RC plus IB RB plus VBE plus beta times IB RE equal to 0. So what we take, this is IB, this is IB, this is IB, this we take common, that is IB into beta times RC plus RB plus beta times RE equal to VCC minus VBE. So what we take, IB equal to VCC minus VBE divided by RB plus beta into RC plus R. This is the base current for DC feedback biasing circuit. And if we know the base current, we can simply write that collector current equal to beta times of base current. So this we know, whatever we are having in collector current. Now we can simply write the equation of KVL from this circuit of right hand side, that is the output point. So here what we write, if we start in this point, that is collector emitter loop KVL. So starting from this point, it is minus VCC, this is plus IC bar RC plus VCE plus IER. Now from our previous essay we can write IC bar is almost equal to IC because base current is very less. This is IC RC plus VCE plus, we can write collector current and emitter current is almost same. So this IE we replace by IC. So now it is just the like previous equation. So you can simply write VC equal to VCC minus IC into RC plus R. So from here we can simply find what is the value of VCE. And if you know what is the value of VCE, we can take any voltage at any terminal, that is collector, emitter or base terminal, just we have seen in the first example. So this is the second loop is complete. So in today's lecture we have seen that there are four types of biasing circuit of BJT. So what we can take, we can draw each circuit and we simply take the two loop, that is input loop and output loop. We draw the write the KVL equation from input loop, that is generally our base emitter loop. We solve the base current, and from the base current we convert it to the, we multiply it to the beta, we get the collector current. This collector current we use in the second loop, that is our right hand side loop, that is output loop, that is generally collector emitter loop. And from there we can find out the value of voltage between collector emitter, that is VCE. And if we find these parameters, whatever the current and voltage values we want to find, we can find from the KVL equation. Okay, thank you.